All right, so in this video here, we're going to go over how to add a ClickPop to your order page. And primarily, we want it to be an exit pop as they're exiting. We don't want to give them an option to opt in unless they're already on their way out. So what we'll need to do is actually add in a ClickPop template or page. So I'm just going to add a new one. Let's call it exit pop, or you can call it ClickPop. Path doesn't really matter. We can just call it pop. Something fun like that. All right, we're going to get taken to the templates and page types. So let's go over here to ClickPop. I like to just use this basic ClickPop. Everything's inside of it. Don't have to worry about transparency or anything like that. So what you may want to do is look at the animation for the page, or the pop-up, I should call it. So if we edit the section of the ClickPop and go to advanced, you'll see there's an animation tab here, and you can actually remove that. And that'll help reduce the loading time if you find that it's a bit long when it's all set up. So I'm just going to go ahead and save that. We don't necessarily need to worry about the SEO meta on that. No one sees the title or the link to the page. So what you can do is go ahead and customize this section. And once you're done doing that, we'll exit. All right, so you can see here we have an exit pop. It's at the bottom of the funnel. No one's going to see that funnel, or sorry, that page, or get to that page. You know, somebody buys something or goes to the thank you page. Unless we, you know, specifically put this URL somewhere in a button, or they go to a page, maybe this funnel step, and the button is set to send them to the next funnel step. So if you're familiar in the editor, you know what I'm talking about. And so, you know, you'd probably put your digital asset in that page if you are sending them to the thank you page. So back to the ClickPop. We'll go here to the publishing tab. And we're going to get the ClickPop code. And you may want to open up a notepad or something like that, because we need to copy this. And we only need some of this text. What else here is important to note is that we want this to trigger on exit. And keep in mind, there's no mouse when they're on mobile, so this is only for desktop people that are going to see that pop up. Of course, you can set up on a timer, that sort of thing. And there's some documents on how to use it, you know, regularly with as an image and so on. But for now, we're just going to go ahead and copy all of this text after we've made sure that the trigger on mouse exit was turned on. So let me just double check I have that. Now we're going to come to our order form page. All right, so what I can do here, I'm going to go to the settings, then tracking code. I like to put this type of code in the footer. I'm sure it works fine in the header. So you'll notice it's pretty long, so I'm just going to kind of shrink that down a bit. And that way it all fits. So we need all this code here. The image source, none of this really matters. There's no, let me see here. Because we're not actually using an image or the text. So it doesn't look like there's any text to click. So if I actually go ahead and save that, preview the page, and my mouse goes to leave and close the tab, you'll notice that the ClickPop shows up here. All right, so of course I can close that sort of thing. And if I was going to order, I would go ahead and order right then and there. So next, what's important to note about the ClickPop is that they're technically opting in on this funnel step, even though they see it while they're over here. So since there's no next funnel step, it might just refresh this page or take them to this page. So I'm going to use this here, this thank you page, as an example. You can go ahead and add a new one in here if you want. You know, they're just signed up for the free book. They turned down the offer. What we're going to do is grab the desired page address, right? So, you know, you've got the download page or, hey, the email's on the way, confirmation page. And we're going to go back and edit the ClickPop page. You may already be familiar with this setting for pages, opt-in pages, and so on. Under settings, general settings, and we're going to set the on submit go to URL. Now make sure you're using the keyboard shortcuts, and if you're not familiar with Control C or Command C and Command V, all of that, copy and paste, you can just try and delete the last number or backspace, re-add it in, and then just keep hitting delete so there's no extra space at the end, because that will not be a good experience for your visitors. All right, so now what I've done there, I'm going to go ahead and refresh this page. You'll kind of get an example of what I've just done. So if I go ahead and opt in on this, or sorry, purchase on this page, I'm going to go to the order confirmation or the upsell page respectively. And then if I go to exit here, you're going to see when I opt in, it's going to take me to the page. And so you can see here, I've got the email set up. I'm going to submit, and now it's going to send me to this page, the one I wanted it to. So at least they know they successfully opted in. You can send them to a new sales page, whatever you want to do, wherever you want to send them, it's totally up to you. And that's how you can add a ClickPop to your order page. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment below. Of course, the ClickFunnels support team is great. They'll be able to troubleshoot any issues or any possible technical issues you may have. With that, and you know, this video was inspired by a question in the comments, so if you have any questions, please ask away, and maybe I'll shoot a video for you as well.